Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel and let's do some freshest PSVR news in the village. Today, of course, we have to mention this PlayStation 5 UI because it's got revealed, but also we're gonna have a release date for a upcoming kart racing game, and also we're gonna talk a bit about the Swordsman and its upcoming update. So maybe let's just jump into it. Let's start from this PlayStation 5 UI reveal. So the event was very interesting. I've been at work when it's been happening, so I was like, oh no, I can't watch it. I'm gonna watch it after then at home. So I did. But anyway, looks very similar to what we've got now, but very streamlined as well version of it. Also the more enjoyable version sounds like it, because what they do in it, they've got like pop-ups during the game as well. You can watch other people play the games. Everything seems to work faster. Sometimes when I go to my PS4 and trying to go to the store, it takes a bit of time to load for some reason, even though I got fast internet now. So you know what, it looks like it's just gonna be all in all better experience. Sadly, what I was waiting for, maybe a bit of information about PlayStation VR, but once again, they proved me right that they sticking to their rule of not talking about PSVR at all, because why would they? It's only 6 million people waiting for some information, but as they reassured us not that long ago, we will get this adapter for our cameras and we'll be able to use the PSVR on PS5. Fun fact as well, one of my buddies, YouTube buddies, that guy is Will, he pointed out on Twitter that PS4 version of Hitman got the PSVR compatible sign, so at least that's confirmation that it's gonna be supported on PS4 as well, but PS5 version of Hitman 3 VR do not have PSVR sign, and that is very, very strange. So maybe just placeholder box art, I don't know, or maybe they're not gonna do that anymore, I don't know, but you know, we still know that Hitman will support the PSVR, so maybe it's just gonna be through the backwards compatibility, so we might not have any improvements on PS5, I don't know. Sony keeps quiet about everything and it just does my head in, but I trust them. I know, I'm assuming they know what they're doing, so very soon we're gonna be hopefully rewarded for our patience, and it's not, if not, then sad times. But anyway, moving on to the next story, let's talk about the Swordsman and what's happening with this game, because I really like it. It's super fun, like this combat arena fighter with swords and stabs in the head. But the developer working on the update, one of the complaints was that the swords going through the armor, and they said they've done it on purpose, but because people didn't like it really, so what they're doing now, the update gonna bring you, like, you won't be able to stab somebody through their armor on, you know, their helmet, on their head. So now you're gonna have to proper aim to get into this eyeball socket. So that's cool, but of course you'll be able to disable it. They still pretty much pushing for all the updates, like they said. This one is a bit delayed, but they've had some more stuff to do, they say in. But also don't forget the new game mode will be coming soon. The brand new axe dropped other day. So now we've got this, them three axes, what come with axe update, but now I think we've got four. I didn't follow it for a while, so I'm gonna have to jump back into it. But yeah, big shout out to Sin Studios, because they definitely supporting this game big time, and they're gonna add even more things, like, you know, you'll be able to chop the head and limbs off, so that's gonna be nice. I'm hearing they're gonna work about grabbing and better grappling system, blunt weapons, so this game just gonna keep getting better and better. Speaking about game, let's speak about another game, and this game is Galaxy Kart. So this is an upcoming kart racer and it's got the release date. It's gonna be with us next year on 21st of February. Now, I do not know if it's gonna be on PS4 or on PS5 or PS5 through the backwards compatibility. As I'm saying, it's all confusing, nobody knows nothing, so Sony tell me something, but I don't know why I said that, they're not gonna. But maybe one day they will. Keep being patient, I'm saying to myself, and I'm getting sad about it. Never mind, I'm just rambling on. So this is a game from the same studio that brought you Apocalypse Rider and Viking Days, but of course Apocalypse Rider was a mobile game. This one looks like it's proper design, you know, not for the mobile devices. So that will be with us soon. We do not have enough racing games on PlayStation VR. I know it's yet another kart racer, but at least it's a racer, so I'm happy about it. Okay, anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.